So far, we have seen how to add and subtract vectors, and we have seen how to multiply vectors by scalars. This might lead you to ask, can we multiply two vectors? It turns out that there are several different notions of vector multiplication. Perhaps the first one we might think of, just multiplying corresponding coordinates, doesn't turn out to be useful in many applications. However, there are other notions of multiplication which are very useful. One of the most important operations we can perform on vectors is the inner product, also called the dot product, since we often represent it by placing a dot between the vectors being multiplied. Its importance stems from its geometric interpretation. It lets us find the angle between two different vectors. More precisely, the inner product of the vectors v and w in Euclidean space satisfies the following identity. V dot w equals the magnitude of v times the magnitude of w times the cosine of theta, where theta is the angle between the vectors v and w if we were to draw them emanating from the same point. Technically, there are two angles between the vectors, a shorter one and a longer one. We always use the shorter one by convention. Note that the inner product of two vectors is a number, not a vector. Using the inverse of the cosine function, also called the arc cosine, we can solve for this angle. It equals the arc cosine of the dot product of v and w divided by the product of the magnitudes of v and w. Another way we can think of this formula is as the following. The arc cosine of the normalization of v dotted with the normalization of w. Of course, unless we have a nicer way of computing the dot product of two vectors, this formula doesn't do us much good. It turns out that there is a nicer way to compute the inner product, and it is similar to our first candidate notion for multiplying vectors. To compute v dot w, we can multiply the corresponding components of v and w, and then we can add those products together. So, for example, the dot product of the vectors 1, 2, minus 1, and 3, 1, 0 is 1 times 3 plus 2 times 1 plus negative 1 times 0, which equals 5. This means that the angle between these two vectors is the dot product of v and w, which is 5, divided by the magnitude of v, which is the square root of 6, and the magnitude of w, which is the square root of 10. This gives about 0.87 radians, which is about 50 degrees. There are some interesting consequences of this connection between the inner product of two vectors and their angle. First, recall that the cosine of x is always bounded below by negative 1 and above by 1, no matter what x is. Using the earlier equation, that the dot product of v and w is the product of the magnitudes times cosine of theta, we see that the dot product is bounded below by negative magnitude of v times magnitude of w, and above by magnitude of v times magnitude of w. We can express this inequality more succinctly as the absolute value of v dot w is less than or equal to the product of the magnitudes of v and w. This is a famous inequality called the Koshi-Schwarz inequality, and you will see this inequality pop up all over linear algebra and mathematics in general. Let's assume for the moment that neither v nor w is the zero vector, which would mean that their dot product is automatically zero. What does it mean if v dot w actually equals the magnitude of v times the magnitude of w? From our earlier equation, it means that the cosine of theta equals 1, and this tells us that theta must equal 0 in both degrees and in radians. In other words, the vectors v and w are pointing in the same direction. Similarly, if v dot w equals the negative of the product of the magnitudes, we can conclude that cosine of theta equals negative 1, which means that theta equals pi radians, or 180 degrees. And that in turn means that v and w are pointing in opposite directions. Finally, if v dot w equals 0, then, since we assumed that neither v nor w was the zero vector, this means that cosine of theta must equal 0. This means that theta equals pi over 2 radians, or 90 degrees. So v and w are at a right angle to each other. One last thing to consider is what happens when you take the dot product of a vector with itself. In this case, the angle between the two vectors is zero, both radians and degrees. So, cosine of theta will equal 1. So our formula reduces to v dot v equals the magnitude of v squared. After a little rearrangement, we can see that the magnitude of v equals the square root of v dot v. This gives us another interpretation of the magnitude of a vector, this time in terms of its dot product.